live IELTS class. My name is Adrian, and I'm streaming to you from beautiful Central Europe. I hope everybody is having a great week so far. Hi, Zen. Hi, Anjali. Abdul Aziz. Z, nice to see many students in the class for this task two writing lesson. And we're going to talk about how to get a true band 9 or a very high score on your task two essay. Hi, David. Hi, Catherine. Hi, Nick Hill. Nice to see many of our regular students and members. I hope you're all doing fantastic. In this class, students, we are going to look at how to plan the essay and how to write an effective introduction, and we'll do that in just a moment. This lesson is presented to you by aehelp.com. That's academicenglishhelp.com, where we have lots of help for you to pass the IELTS exam, as well as gieltshelp.com. That's generalieltshelp.com. On both of those websites, we have original practice exams, HD videos, and interactive courses. This is the Academic AE Help. Click the red button to join. And this is the General with the green background. Click that big red button to join us there. Hi, Murdy, Loy9, and welcome, Ois. Okay, students, if you have questions, just send me an email to adrian@aehelp.com. I will gladly answer your questions. And we'll get right into our task two today. The question is right here. IELTS task two writing. You should spend about 40 minutes on this task. Many people work long hours to make enough money for everyday life and have little time to spend with family and entertainment. What are the causes and solutions to this situation? Give explanations and examples to support the arguments in the essay. Okay, now, because you are doing a lot of reading in the IELTS, you finished the reading section, I highly recommend reading the task two question twice before you do anything. So read it again. Okay, many people work long hours to make enough money for everyday life and have little time to spend with family and entertainment. What are the causes and solutions to this situation? Now, your first step is to paraphrase the question. This is not the introduction. Okay, so step one, paraphrase. The question for clarity, ideas, and vocabulary. So many of your IELTS teachers and online videos will tell you, oh, paraphrase, that's your introduction, that's the beginning. No, not for a true band 9 essay. Again, today's topic is a true band 9 essay. And for a true band 9 essay, just paraphrasing the introduction is far from enough. If you look at the task two marking criteria, you will see this. Okay, I'm not making it up. Just look at the marking criteria available to the public for task two writing. Okay, so paraphrase the question. You do this for clarity and for ideas and for vocabulary. So go ahead. Paraphrase this. Paraphrase means write it using your own words, using synonyms, descriptive language, okay? So paraphrase the question, okay? All right, there's my paraphrase. So let's see how you did. Un says, individuals work around the clock to make ends meet. Hence, they do not have time for family and relaxations. What are the reasons and measures to tackle this problem? Un, that is some beautiful paraphrasing. Good job. I can tell that you've really thought about it. Good for you. Individuals work around the clock to make ends meet is a fantastic way to paraphrase that. Moria says, many individuals work overtime to earn money for their daily expenses and spend less time relaxing and being with family. What are the reasons for this and how can this condition be solved? Very good, Moria. I just did a little bit of correcting there to make it even better. Okay. Noman, that's right. I am Adrian. I'm actually from Victoria, Canada. I'm just currently momentarily in Budapest. Okay. Zen says, a lot of individuals work around the clock to earn enough cash for day-to-day life and spend only a few hours with family members and relaxation. Very nice. I like how some of you are realizing that, hey, wait a second, let's start quantifying many hours and few hours, and that's brilliant. Okay, very, very good. Nick Hill says, certain individuals do work 9 to 10 hours a day to earn a salary for everyday life and have a short time to spend with family and enjoyment. What are the reasons and solutions? Very nice, Nick Hill. Again, nice quantitative language. So already starting to think about numbers to better explain that. Nicely done, everyone. So that's the first step. We're just paraphrasing. We're making sure that we understand the question. We're getting some vocabulary and we're starting to get some clear ideas of what we might need to write about here. This is what I wrote. Millions of individuals work many hours to earn enough money for sustenance needs. Sustenance needs, teaching you some vocabulary here, are your needs for survival. So another way to think of sustenance is to sustain or survival needs, okay? Survival needs, sustenance needs. What creates this situation and how can it be avoided? So what leads to this situation? How can it be avoided? There are many, many ways to paraphrase, okay? So this should be quick. Now, this is not your introduction, but it doesn't mean that it's not useful, okay? Keep that in mind. So it's not like you've just wasted some time. So this is not your introduction, but it may be useful in some parts of the essay, okay? So keep it in mind. Now, if you're in the computer-based exam, that's great because you can type this down and then you might be able to just grab and copy-paste into your essay at some point. Maybe the introduction, maybe the conclusion. Anyway, the words will be really useful, like sustenance needs, okay? All right. So what's the topic here? What are we talking about? Always think about the topic. To think about the topic means that you can focus on it so that your essay is specific, okay? One of the most important task to marking criteria, you will see this on the IELTS public marking sheet for task two, is to have a specific and clear essay on the topic, okay? So what's the topic here? What are we talking about? Yeah, so Owis says it's working long hours. Okay. Yeah. I would say there's a little, there we go. So Roshni Kunte has the full topic. Roshni says it's not just working long hours, but it's working long hours for sustenance. Okay, that's the topic. That's what we're talking about. Always get the full topic. So working long hours for sustenance. Okay. Okay, that's the full topic. That's what we're talking about. All right. And what's the controlling idea? So get the full topic. So it's not just working long hours. That's only half. Okay. For sustenance is the other half. Everybody clear on that? Some people work long hours, make a ton of money, not just for sustenance, but they have enough money to buy a second house, a yacht, a Ferrari. Okay, so this is specifically working long hours for sustenance, All right. So is that clear? That's the full topic? That's exactly what we're talking about here. Now, the controlling idea, what's that? So the controlling idea, you should always think about, like, what are we talking about here? So what in connection to the topic? So when you think of the controlling idea, you should think, what are we talking about in connection to working long hours for sustenance? So Un says, the controlling idea is discussing its causes and its solutions. Yeah, very good. So discussing its causes and solutions so that people can engage more with family and entertainment. Possibly, right? So focusing especially on the causes and solutions. Okay, great. All right. So now we can think what, why, how for each of these. To build a and write a band 9 essay, you have to have a clear idea of what you're talking about, why you're talking about it, and how you're going to discuss it, okay, in your writing, of course. Now, you need to do that twofold, once for the topic, once for the controlling idea, okay? So what does it mean to work long hours for sustenance? So what does that actually mean? In your world, different people have different ideas about this, and when you're writing a good essay, it's super important that your reader and you have the same idea. You cannot assume that your reader has the same experiences and same beliefs, okay? So you have to write for your audience, not for yourself. That's one of the biggest mistakes by many writers, is they write for themselves, okay? So what does it mean working long hours for sustenance? That's right, Amrit, okay? So Nushrat says working more than one job, okay? Bekjan, good to see you, says spending a lot of time in the workplace and making ends meet. That's just a paraphrase, Bekjan. Let's try to be a little bit more descriptive here, okay? So Tiger World, please read statements for me. I just want to attend the class. This will help me participate in it. Tiger World, I'm not sure where you're going with that, but okay. So Moria says the basic necessities like food, shelter, and providing for family. Very good, Moria. That's on the right track. Okay. All right. So working morning until night, 12 hours to... pay for food, shelter, and clothes. Okay. Sure. So why? Not cloths, clothes. Remember, students, there's an E there, clothes, not cloths. There's no E, it's just cloths. We're talking about clothes. Okay, so that's what it means, right? So working morning until night, 12 hours to pay for food, shelter, clothes. That's the definition of what it means to work long hours for sustenance needs. Okay? All right, makes sense. So why do people do that? Why do people work for long hours for their basic needs? Why does that happen? Okay, and I saw some really good answers here. So Lubna says, psychologically and mentally invest your time and energy in earning money for fulfilling basic needs. Hi, Lubna. Yes, that's pretty good. Think of many hours too. Lubna, don't overcomplicate for IELTS. It's a 250, 300 word essay. It's not your master's thesis for university. So, okay. Sam says, to lead to a luxurious lifestyle, but no, that's not why we do it, Sam. That's a different idea. Natalie, Nikki Farova says, because wages are low and prices are high. Many, very good, Nikki. Very good. Or sorry, Natalie. Natalie, very good, Natalie. So Natalie says, this happens because wages are low and the cost of living is very high. Rapid inflation. Okay, somebody used the word inflation. Inflation is where money is losing its value. Okay. And that was a good word to use. Okay, that's very nice. Yeah, so David Valencia is saying, capital letters, inflation. Yeah, and inflation, in some sense, David, if you're thinking about it as it's defined, then it means that wages are low and the cost of living is very high. Okay, how? Give me an example of that. So the how can we see this in society? Okay, so when you're thinking of the how, you should just think of an example. Okay, so think example. All right, I'll show you what I mean. When you think of the how, just think of the example. Okay, so nurse makes $30, rent is $2,000 a month. Okay. Dollars per hour. Okay. And rent is $2,000 a month. Okay. So let's just kind of simplify it. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's just an example. Okay. So the nurse makes $30 an hour. Yeah. Okay. But rent is $2,000 an hour. Many people around the world think, oh, yeah. Okay. In some countries, nurses make so much money and it's so great. It's true. But in many of those places, rent, cost of food are much, much higher than in other places. Right? So, and the nurse is working from morning until night, even though they're making $30 an hour, they have to work a lot just to pay their rent. Okay, they have to work close to 70 hours just for rent. And then let's not even talk about food, car, telephone, and other basic needs that people have these days. All right, and so now we've kind of understood some of the controlling ideas as well. Okay, so always start with the topic. Always start the what, why, and how with the topic. This will often reveal answers for the controlling idea as well, okay? All right. So always start with the topic. Don't try to be quick and skip the topic. Now, again, I'm teaching you how to get those really high bands for your task two essay. And some of you might be thinking, well, Adrian, I only have 40 minutes. What do you want me to do? Really, you want me to go through all these steps? Yes, I do. When you practice this at home during the exam, much of this, most of this planning phase is happening in your head. And this is only taking you maybe 4 or 5 minutes. Okay, so you're writing the essay for 35 minutes, but you want to do about 4 or 5 minutes of planning because you will have a much better essay. Okay, quality over quantity, right? Okay. We have the answer to the causes, okay, of why this is happening. So we can kind of jump in the controlling idea and we can start thinking of solutions because we already have some of the answers for the causes. So I can ask here, what are the causes of this? And we can answer low wages, inflation, okay. Low demand, not enough or lack of education, poor economy. Okay, so we can answer that. What are the solutions? So what are the solutions to working too many hours for everyday needs. Okay, let's start thinking about that. Okay, so we have the high living costs in there. So what can we do to make enough money or make more money in less time? Okay, Begjun says regulation by government. Okay, Banu says further education and find different sources of income. Okay. Z says, learn to make passive income. I'm still looking for one word. Zen Frederick says, immigrate. That might not solve it. Might, but it might help, but it might not. Immigrate. Yep. Okay. Increase salary. Okay. Yeah, Katan Patel says, improve your investment portfolio. So, start investing wisely. Katan says, just investment. Okay. Nomon says, stealing money. I think, Nomon, you mean stealing money, but then you might lose your freedom. So, I don't recommend that. And Samuel says, switch jobs. I still haven't seen another one that is a really good way to change this up. And that's start a business, right? You might be really busy at first to get going. Yeah, there we go. On Mapari and Natalie at the same time. Okay, now, this is IELTS, everyone. So you can't write all about this. I mean, we could write a whole book on the topic of how to make more money and have more free time. In fact, there are lots of books that people have written, I'm sure in every language, about this topic. So you can't write about all of this because you're just not going to be able to finish your essay and you won't get a good score, okay? So keep that in mind. In the IELTS, you do not have enough time to include all of the ideas here. So you must choose just two or three of the best ideas to write about that are easy and clear. Okay. Now within that, you want to be original. Okay. So we have a lot of solutions here. We have, and don't forget, we have to write about the causes too. So writing about causes and solutions. So further education, finding different sources of income, learning to make passive income, immigrating, increasing salary, start investing, change jobs, start a business. Okay, so if I had to choose, if I have all these ideas floating around in my head, I would boil it down to these two, okay? And I think a lot of people here are thinking the same way because I believe that many of you are learning IELTS so that you can get into a better position in life and you can make more money so you have more time for family, friends, hobbies, as well you're in a more comfortable, enjoyable job, right? So don't get too creative. I mean, be creative, but think about your situation, right? This is what many of you are doing, I'm sure. So further education, so you get a better job, you make more money. I think that's a fairly logical approach. Also, I'd like to think, you know, think about what you can do to change your situation, not what others can do, because of course governments can help, you can win the lottery, people can help, but think about what you can do to make your life better. First of all, be educated. That's one of the best investments that you can make, and then you can find a better job. And then of course the other one is whenever you have the chance to put a little money aside and invest into the stock market, into cryptocurrency, whatever that might be, to have money working for you. So have money making money, okay? That's the name of the game. So that's another type of solution. All right. So we have the causes. We have the solutions. Now we just need to put all of that into one clear thesis, okay? So causes, low wages, high prices, solutions, education, and investing, okay? Now, it's the IELTS. Your goal here is not to convince the world. Your goal here is to write a good essay. So your thesis has to be a clear argument that includes these points. Okay? And notice here something interesting. It's not a first person. So you're not using I, me, my, because the original question doesn't ask you for the first person. If you don't see you in the question, then it's a third person essay, okay? That means that you cannot use I or me or my or us or we or you in the essay. It has to be third person. So here, the original question is, many people work long hours to make enough money for everyday life and have little time to spend with family and entertainment. What are the causes and solutions to this situation? Give examples and explanations to support the arguments in the essay. There are no you words used here. So you have to use a third person essay. This is very academic, okay? All right, so again, going back here, causes, solutions, thesis, okay? Bekshin says the two main causes of working long hours are low wages and inflation. Fortunately, there are some solutions to this problem, which are further education and wise investment. Okay, good, Bekjan. I like it. All right. That's a good thesis statement. All right. Keep going. I want to see some more. I'm going to write my own here. Okay. There we go. Let's see what you have. Ann says, arguably the main causes of this issue are low wages and high prices, and the solutions are higher education and wise investment, or wiser investment. Higher education, Ann, wiser investment. Okay, have parallel grammar. Higher, wiser, relative, relative. Okay, all right. Vaishnavi says, people working around the clock to meet their cost of living. On the contrary, they're losing their precious time to spend with loved ones. You're just repeating the question, Vaishnavi. That is not a thesis. That will not get you a good band score. Okay. This is my thesis. The causes of being overworked are low wages and high prices, while the solutions lie in more education and investing. Okay, so I kept mine fairly simple. It's one sentence. And it includes all of those points. You don't need to overthink it. All right? Okay. Amrit says, the reasons behind working morning to evening are low wages and high prices, period. Some valuable solutions are investing and education. Careful, Amrit, with your parallel grammar. Don't use although there. It's awkward, okay? But you have the right idea. You just have to make sure it's correct, all right? Okay, Roshni says, the origin of working longer hours for sustenance are low wages and minimum education, although the solutions are higher education and starting a business. Okay, Roshni, you're taking a different approach. That's good. Roshni, don't repeat words. So low education and more learning, OK? Okay, so always paraphrase. So are low wages and education. So low wages, low education. You can use both. So Roshni, simplify wherever you can. Okay, so one more time, Roshni. The origin of working longer hours for sustenance are low wages and education, while the solutions are higher learning and better business. That would be a good thesis statement. Different ideas, but also a very good thesis statement. Okay, Roshni, write down what I just said. If you missed it, go back and check it, okay? For now, everyone, we're going to stay on this thesis statement so that we can all work on this Band 9 essay together, all right? Victor says, the two main reasons of working a lot are low salary and inflation. There are some solutions as getting education and investing that can help people prevent this. Good, Victor. Now, it's the IELTS, Victor, so don't get too specific right away. Investing into stocks, firstly, you don't have parallel grammar in your thesis anymore because of that. Plus, it's too specific. So just explain that later. You can explain stock investment in the body paragraph. Okay, investing into blue chip stocks like Apple and Google will almost always or almost always bring more money than spending money on shoes or putting it in the bank. Okay, so you can do that later, Victor, when you get into the body paragraphs. All right, so now, students, let's write the introductory paragraph. Okay, so the introduction has three parts. A lot of people forget, especially the second part, which is the background. Okay, so the introduction has a hook, a background, and the thesis. I'm not making this up. This isn't the Adrian method. Okay, I think sometimes students get a little bit confused by this. They maybe think that I made this up or it's Adrian's kind of amazing writing tactics. But no, that's not it at all. If you go to high school in Canada, where I went to school, or the US or UK or Australia, and you're in your high school English class, your high school English teacher will tell you that to write a good persuasive essay, the introduction should have a hook, a background, and a thesis. That's standard. It's like essay writing 101 basics. Okay, it's not an Adrian technique or structure. It's the way it is, all right? So the hook, just to be clear, and sometimes, you know, students say, oh, but in the IELTS, you don't need a hook. That's not true. If you want to get a band 8 or a band 9, yeah, you need a hook, okay? If you want to get a high score, you need a hook, all right? Good essays that have get high scores include a hook. End of story. It's no argument, okay? Any good IELTS or English teacher, if they sat the IELTS exam today, they would write a hook for their task 2 essay. Period. End of question. Okay? All right? So the hook is a simple, interesting fact that includes the topic, okay? And should be, for the IELTS, should be just 8 to 12 words. Now, that's a little bit of my advice, okay, because the hook can actually be as long as you want, but if you make mistakes, it's a problem. So on the IELTS, you never want to start your essay with mistakes, and that's why I say just keep it simple, okay? All right, so that you avoid mistakes in your first sentence, okay? So the topic is working long hours for sustenance needs, okay? That should be included in your topic, and it should be some kind of an interesting fact. So Zen says, working hours depends on sustenance needs. Ferdov says, being overworked kills millions of people every year. I love it, Ferdov. That is a very powerful hook. Okay. Millions of people suffer from being overworked. That There we go. How about that one? That's using yours for Dov's and just tweaking it a little bit. Also using a little bit of what Un said. Okay. The hook is not the introduction, Nawal. The hook is just the hook. The whole paragraph is going to be your introduction. Okay. All right. So here's my hook. Millions of people suffer from being overworked to make ends meet. Okay. If you read this, let's say, you know, forget the IELTS, forget everything. Let's say that, you know, you're just flipping through your mobile phone for different articles. Okay. So overworked to make ends meet means working long hours to pay for everyday needs. So that's the topic, Zen. The topic is right there. Okay. And suffer is including the question as well, because not having time for family and for entertainment, that's suffering. Okay. If we're not having fun and we're not enjoying the company of others, then we're suffering, right? Okay. So all I'm doing here is doing some paraphrasing of the topic. So working long hours for everyday needs, overworked to make ends meet, okay? Suffer, that's some more paraphrasing there. Little bit of quantitative information. And now, let me ask you this. If you're flipping through your phone for some interesting articles and you read an article that starts with millions of people suffer from being overworked to make ends meet, okay? If you don't know this idiom, you could just write for everyday living or to survive. Okay. If I want to avoid this, I'm not sure what this idiom is, then I can say to survive. So the question again is there a chance that you're going to keep reading? Okay. Victor says millions of people spend the majority of their time at work. That's also a very good one, okay? So again, ask yourself the question, if you read this short sentence in an article on your phone, is there a chance that you might continue reading that article because you will be interested to see what that article says, okay? Quite possibly, right? Quite possibly. Depends on your day and your mood, but there's a good chance that you're gonna keep reading. So yeah, it's a good hook. It's on the topic and it's catching your attention. Okay. All right. And then the part that many people forget to include here is the background. Okay. So now comes the background. And the background is the definition and the importance. Okay. So definition of the key ideas and importance of the essay. Okay. So that's what you're doing here. And this, adding this part to the introduction will right away set your essay apart from a lot of the other essays that the examiners are reading. So when the examiners read an introduction with a good hook, good background, immediately their brain switches to band 8, band 9 category, okay? Ferdov says, individuals stay at the job places for 12 to 16 hours in order to pay for rent, food, commute, and clothes. Okay. Individuals slave away in their workplace for 14 hours each day to afford food, rent, commute, and clothes. Yeah, those are everyday needs. That's your definition. Very good for Dov's. I just took what you said, add a little bit to it, that's it. That's my definition, right? I'm defining what it means to be overworked to survive, okay? I'm giving clarity for my reader. I'm keeping them locked into my essay, right? Okay. Amrita says, today people give more attention to earn money for a bright future and advanced facilities for their offspring, so they don't care about working hours. Amrita, you're off topic. Okay, that's another question to work long hours to build a better and brighter future? That's a different question. Go off topic and your essay score will literally nosedive into the ground, okay? Like a meteor or a comet falling from the sky. So you don't want that, all right? Joseph says, breadwinners now have to work multiple jobs to have enough to provide for themselves and their family. Joseph, simplify. You have the right idea. Overcomplicating again, scores go down, okay? Unnecessary wordiness. It's in the task to marking criteria leads to lower scores, okay? So be really, really careful with that, okay? All right, and what's the importance of the question? Okay, why are we talking about this? So why talk about this? Why discuss it? And us, working long hours has affected people's relationship with their families and their daily activities dramatically. Be even more accurate. And us, as people spend most of their time in work and have little time left to spend with their family or entertainment. In this essay, we're going to discuss no, and us. You're not going to discuss. Don't tell me what you're going to discuss. It's wasting my time and it's not interesting for me. Tell me what you're going to discuss. Okay? All right? So, the importance of the question. Let's see if anybody else has come up with something before I give you this. So Un says, this problem has a major impact on people's intimate lives and their mental health. Very good, Un. That's exactly what we're talking about. So this trend has a detrimental effect on people's relationships and overall quality of life. Okay, yeah. So nobody wants to be stuck behind the desk for 14 hours a day or slaving away in some physical labor. Absolutely. And then comes the thesis, okay? All right. So let me just put that in there. I'm just going to grab the thesis that I already have. Why not? So copy that and paste it in. You can do this in the computer-based exam, which is quite nice. And now you have your high band introduction, okay? So this is your band 9 introduction. Not according to me, according to the IELTS marking criteria. Original, well-structured essay showing fluency, coherence, connectivity, okay, with the right words. Here we go. Have a look at this with me. So millions of people suffer from being overworked to survive. Individuals slave away in their workplace for 14 hours each day to afford food, rent, commute, and clothes. This trend has a detrimental effect on people's relationship and overall quality of life. The causes of being overworked. Now, because I used overworked at the top of long working hours, I'm going to change it here. Okay, just because I have overworked and I don't want to repeat words. So the causes of long working hours are low wages and high prices, while the solutions lie in more education and investing. Okay, so that is your band 9 introduction. I'll show you what a band 6 introduction looks like. Okay, so a band 6 intro like this, where I just have a paraphrase, and I did that already, so I'm just going to grab it. Okay. All right, let me just grab that, put it in there. So this is the paraphrase of the question, and then this essay will discuss the causes and possible solutions to this phenomenon. Okay, So this is your band six, okay? Band six introduction. Millions of individuals work many hours to earn enough money for sustenance needs, but have only a few hours to be with loved ones and to have fun. This essay will discuss the causes and possible solutions of this phenomenon. Nice vocabulary, nice grammar, but it's poor essay writing, okay? This would be considered, at best, junior high school, low-level high school essay writing, and this would be considered college, university-level essay writing. This is clear to any English teacher who teaches literature and writing, okay? Is that clear? So does everybody see the difference between these two? This doesn't necessarily, if again, so remember what I asked here. If you read this hook, millions of people suffer from being overworked to survive, you will probably continue reading this essay. If you read millions of individuals work many hours to earn enough money for sustenance needs, but have only a few hours, you might lose the person right around here and they might click to a different article. Okay. And if you lost the person, they click to a different article, you can't argue that it's good writing. Okay. Yeah, and then Ois will do causes in body paragraph one and solutions in body paragraph two. Okay. Okay. So, David, you always need the background. Okay. Always take a minute to write a definition of the key idea and the importance of the question. Think about it, students. Why would you read an essay if the author doesn't tell you why it's important to think about that idea? Okay? So it only makes sense, right? So that's the difference between band nine and a band six. Too many students, I still see this kind of band six kind of introduction. A lot of people can do this. You cannot get a band eight or a band nine with this. Otherwise, everybody would score a band eight or a band nine on the IELTS, and that's just not it. I want everybody to score a band eight, band nine, so I want you to write like this, okay? All right, tomorrow we will continue this essay and we will continue with band nine body paragraphs and a band nine conclusion. So great job, everybody. Thanks for tuning in for this task two writing for a true band nine introduction, not some hocus pocus template that you might see somewhere out there in the great World Wide Web. I will be back tomorrow at the same time to finish this essay with you, to practice, to get the right strategies, to learn true communication skills. aehelp.com for academic IELTS, gieltshelp.com for general IELTS. Do yourself a favor, spend a few dollars, join the premium package. Again, you can do that by clicking the big red button there or there. All right, everyone. I hope to see you tomorrow. Keep up the good work. That's it for me for now. You're very welcome, Mina, Zen, Bai, An. Good work today. I'm Adrian, signing out from Budapest for now. Have a great rest of your evening and sweet dreams if it's late in your country. Bye.